Hello everyone, welcome to a new Quickedit video. This time with an image I wanted to shoot for a long time. And a few weeks ago I finally had the opportunity to take this image. And some of you might know this place. It's the Maria Gern Chapel in the Berchtesgadener area in southern Germany. And for this picture I want to create a car light trails photo. And that means I will be combining multiple images. For this shot, the base adjustments will be done in Adobe Lightroom and the later merging will of course be done in Adobe Photoshop. So before I start, let's first check out the before and after images. So then let's start with the base image and I'm activating the lens corrections first to remove chromatic aberrations and remove lens distortion. Then next, I'm changing the camera profile to Adobe Standard, just because this will help me restore some details from the darker areas already, and this way reduce the contrast throughout the image a little bit, so I just have more control over it myself. For this image, I don't want to change the white balance, since I already quite like the colors, but I also want to boost them by just increasing the vibrance. And then instead of doing a lot of global adjustments, I want to go straight to the local adjustments. So let's start by using the gradiated filters. As you can see, I have already added 3 of those gradiated filters. So let's start with the top one first. For this shot, I want to have a nice red or even purple-like sky. And it should be rather dark actually. So let's just drop the exposure first here. Of course, this gradiated filter will now also affect the mountains, which I actually don't want to happen, but I can easily fix that by activating the luminance range mask. And now instead of affecting the whole range of luminance, I can simply change the value and drag up this slider a little bit, so only the brighter areas are affected. Alright, then let's go to the next gradiated filter. I want to use this one to work a little bit more on the upper right side of the image, since the highlights up there are really bright. And I want to fix that by simply dropping the highlights. Alright. And then we have one gradiated filter left. And this one is just to add some structure to the mountains in the back. So let's increase the clarity first. And maybe also add some dehaze. Alright. And again, you can see this gradiated filter affects the trees on the left side, which might start to look a little bit weird. So again, I want to apply this filter only to the mountain range in the back. So let's activate a color range mask this time. Pick the eyedropper tool and select one of those blue color tones from the mountain range. And let's increase the mount a bit. Okay. In this case, we could even add some more clarity maybe and slightly reduce the saturation. And maybe let's add some contrast. All right. Then let's go on with the radial filters. Actually, there's only one and that's for the forest part on the right center side of the image. And here I want to reduce the clarity to make this area a little bit softer, since there's quite much going on, but I don't think that area is that interesting. Alright, and maybe we could also increase the shadows, so the image isn't that dark. Okay, that's it for the local adjustments for now. Then let's go on with some color grading. Now in the last video someone mentioned I should work a little bit more with the green tones, but in my opinion images from the autumn season don't really work that well with the green color tones, so I'm usually going into the hue tab and drop the green hue all the way down just to make the green tones warmer. But once spring is back I will be using the green tones more often. Then let's go to the saturation tab and maybe boost the blue saturation just a little bit. Alright, and finally the split toning, where I only want to apply a warm color tone to the highlights. and this will mainly affect the sky. So let's increase the saturation a bit more. Okay, and then finally some sharpening. And that's the editing for the base image in Lightroom. Now, since I'm merging multiple images for the car light trails, I'm selecting every image I will need later and simply hit the synchronize button to synchronize all the settings. Once that is done, I'm selecting all the images and then right click on them, go to edit in and open as layers in Photoshop. Alright. You can see Lightroom stacked all those images in one Photoshop file. But before I'm merging the car light trails, let's start adjusting the sky first. Here we have the base image, which looks pretty good in my opinion, although the sky is a little bit too bright. So I have another shot right here where the sky just looks way, way better. So let's mask that one in. Therefore, I'm going back to the base image, select it, and since we have a nice clear sky, I can simply use the quick selection tool and roughly paint over the sky area. And you can see Photoshop will make a rough selection here. Then I'm activating the second layer with the dark sky and hit on the layer mask icon. And this way we have simply replaced the original sky. Of course, there are some leftovers from the old sky where Photoshop couldn't make a good selection, but that's not a problem in this case. Here I'm simply selecting the layer mask and use a black brush and carefully paint over those areas a little bit. Actually, I want to use a white brush, not a black brush. And let's also increase the brush opacity. Alright. Perfect. Now next I might want to boost the red tones in the sky some more. So let's create an adjustment layer by hitting on this little icon and apply a hue and saturation adjustment layer. And since I only want to affect the new sky, I'm holding down the Alt key and pressing between those two layers, which will create a clipping mask. So only the layer directly beneath it is affected by this adjustment layer. So let's go to the red color tones and simply boost the saturation. And maybe we can also boost the magentas a bit. Alright, much better. Then let's merge those three layers real quick by selecting them and hitting Ctrl E. Then let's create another hue and saturation adjustment layer. This time target the blue color tones and slightly reduce the saturation, since the mountains in the back are rather saturated and I want to fix that. Alright, much, much better. Maybe I want to leave the blues in the sky, so let's click on that layer mask, set the foreground color to black and use the brush tool to mask that area back in. Okay, and once again, merge those two layers. Then finally, let's add the car light trails. First, I want to go through all those lights images so I can select which one I will be actually using. And in this case, I only want to use the yellow lights, I guess, since the red lights do look kind of strange. Okay, and then to blend those images together, I'm simply selecting the lights layer and change the blending mode to screen. And now we have our lights merged with the base image. Then let's do this for the second layer. Change the blending mode to screen. And we have a merged image. Now, when you're taking a closer look, those light layers will affect the whole image, not only the road in the foreground. And that's rather bad in this case, so I'm creating a layer mask on the light layer, fill it with black by hitting Ctrl I. Then I'm setting the foreground color to white. And again, use the brush tool to paint back in the lights, following the road with the brush. And then let's do that with the second layer as well. Apply a layer mask, invert it, and brush along the road. And that's already it for blending those images together. Then let's merge everything again. And now I want to clean up the image a little bit using the spot healing brush. As you can see, we have some star trails in the sky. Of course, I don't want to have them in this image. Also, I might want to clean up the right side. Then let's add some subtle glow to the car lights in the foreground. So I'm creating a new layer. Switch the blending mode to hard light. Grab the brush tool by pressing B. And now I want to pick a color from the lights in the foreground. So I'm holding down the Alt key with the brush tool selected and click in there. Then let's set the brush opacity to around 10% and carefully paint in some glow. Then let's merge everything one more time and check the Nick collection for some final effects. For this image, the polarization effect will work quite good, since if I boost the strength, the sky will get this nice color boost. So let's apply it like this. And then again, I want to create a selection for the sky by using the quick selection tool and apply another layer mask on that polarization layer. So the mountain range in the back isn't affected by it. But since I also want the foreground to be affected, I'm grabbing a white brush and paint in over the foreground on that layer mask. And finally, let's apply a brightness and contrast adjustment layer and make everything a tiny bit brighter. And here, let's mask out the upper part of the image. Alright, and that's it for editing this car light trails picture. So I hope this was helpful and interesting. Of course, if you have any questions regarding the editing, then please let me know in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.